Okay, we had glued a new tab on this switch, but I put a little force on it and it broke. I think it might have been able to kind of make do if we were gentle. But the new ones came in the mail, so I'll go ahead and remove this old one, solder this new one up, because in the field people aren't going to be gentle with it, so it's best we just get that out of there. And the shipping costs more than the switch, so I ordered like 8 of them. Should I have to repair any more? Also, I got a battery in the mail that should be compatible. If I remember, this battery's good, but the other one needs to be replaced. So we'll check that out. I looked for an exact match, and I could not find this anywhere online. The company still exists, but couldn't find that battery. I don't think it matters. As long as this works, I think any 7.2 NiCad will work. Same number of cells, I believe, so. Okay, we've got the new switch inserted. Time to solder it in. Okay, let's power it up. See what happens. Nice. Okay. It works now. We just have to send it off. It's expired. But it's in good working order. The switch is replaced. And that's beefed up where that pin won't crack. Okay, I've got several power supplies laying around, so we're going to grab one that's 12 volts, 2 amp, to see if we can power this other one up. The thing you got to be concerned about, though, is the polarity. Some power supplies, the polarity is reversed, so we want the ground on the outside, the black, and then the red positive on the inside. So we're just going to test this one real fast to make sure. Plug it in. Red on the inside, black on the outside, and that's correct. So that should work. Let's try it out. See what happens. Okay, so that'll work. This one was missing a power supply. This power supply was damaged and we repaired it. So we're in good shape. I think this one's got the dead battery. I'll let them both charge up and figure it out. I hate to take this back apart if I don't need to, but I'm pretty sure this battery was good. This one was dead. All right, that's not the right screw. It's a little bit too long. We'll trim it down. All right, let's try that. That's a little better. Sweet. Okay, we'll let the batteries charge a little bit. This one had a dead battery, but it also had a bad DC jack. So if we let it charge, it may be okay. This one, the battery was good on. And if not, I'll let it charge a few hours. If not, we'll throw this on there. Okay, so I let this battery charge overnight. And it slowly built up a charge. What do we got? 8.4. So if I unplug the power source, 8.2, and then if I hit this power switch, we can see we've got a battery now. So that's pretty cool. We'll button it up. When I ordered this, I didn't realize I ordered a 1000 milliamp hour, and what I'm replacing is a 1200. So it's probably not a big deal, but if I had noticed that, I would have got the right one. All right, we got two working Kone tools now, albeit one expired, needs to be set in for a reboot. Good deal. This one should be good to go. Should have another, it's got some time on it. Once this gets rebooted, because it's a customer tool, I think it'll have 10 years, which is ridiculous. It should last forever. But I do have an elevator intermittently shutting down. I can go test this one out on tomorrow. So that will come in handy.